All right, good morning. I'm going to try to do a demonstration on drawing this scene. All right, I've already penciled it up. And this is the new Botanical Art Gallery at the Botanic Gardens that just opened yesterday. And because the building is white and the surroundings are dark, I will be using a bit of what they call negative space painting. So negative space painting is basically painting in the negative shapes by painting the areas around it, the dark areas, and leaving the light areas white, right? And this is very key to watercolor painting, because in watercolor you paint the darks, you don't paint the light on top of the darks, right? Because it's a transparent medium, it's not an opaque medium. So unless you are mixing it with gouache or other kinds of medium like acrylics, then maybe you add in the white on top of the darks for highlights. But generally speaking, watercolor alone won't allow you to do that, because you would cover up the darks. Alright, so what we need to do is we'll paint in the darks, and by painting in the darks we'll actually define the whites, the lights, the light areas, which are the positive shapes. Positive shapes are the object itself, alright? So I'm just going to start by filling up the large areas, the largest of which will be the sky and the grass first. And I'll probably need to mix a fair bit of a paint. Okay, I've got my palette up there, but it'll be a bit off screen a bit. And I'm just going to try and get something very light. Might need to neutralize it a little. So I'm going to get some of the sky first. Be careful not to touch the house. It's okay to paint in the trees, because paint over the trees, because we're going to cover it up. So you can always add dark over the light areas, but you can't put light back, so you must be careful to leave out the light, the white areas. This paper is not 100% cotton, so it's not spreading as much as I would like, but it will do for our demo. So that is the sky. Now I will go in to do the grass. Okay. So the lightest portion is gonna be this area, and it's kind of a cooler kind of green sort of, so I'm going to put in some mix of a warm green, green gold with a little bit of phthalo green. Then I'm going to put in some serpentine. It's a little bit bright. You can put in some brown. Some reddish brown to neutralize it a bit. Sure, the sky is dry before you go over the area, otherwise it's going to bleed into each other. Alright, I mean, if it's a grass I don't mind so much, except for those areas where I want the contrast to be quite sharp, like down here, then I should let it dry before I touch each other. But down here you can see what's happening already, it's bleeding. Okay, you can see that I left the house white. And I painted the lightest shades first. The sky, the grass, right? I can always go back and add more values. So next I will paint the pathway down here. It's a light pinkish kind of yellow. And it fades out quite a bit, so I don't need to. Just make sure that the areas I'm painting around is are dry, because I don't want it to spread into those areas. Okay. Right. So for the roof, all right. The roof is a nice reddish orange. So what I'll do is I'll paint around the trees because, well, I don't want the green and the red to mix, or the red-brown rather, otherwise that might cause a bit of a muddy colours. Gotta be a bit careful here because it's quite small. I'm painting at quite a small size. This is A6. Dropping some red in there, warm red. Yeah, then I might pick up some color from here. Dry brush, use a dry brush to pick up the color. Well, it's still a bit dry. Paint has gone past the roof, the eaves. Never mind, I'll use a white pen later. Right. Okay. Maybe the other side house's roof. Right, so you can see I'm leaving this area white. Okay, so before I paint the trees, and I will probably want to add a bit of shadows into this area. A very dilute wash, very dilute. Let's make sure it's dry. Okay, I can go over it a bit later. But you can see the cauliflowering happening already. It's getting, making it worse. I need to drop some paint in. Okay. Okay, the bad part is this thing, you can see that now I've mixed in that area with color which I don't want. See if I can blot it out. I forgot if it's wet, everything gets wet. Even those areas. So I'm going to try and get rid of this splotchiness by adding more paint. Because if you just add watery paint, it will cauliflower. Now I'm going to add the paint in the dark greens. And I'm going to use one of my favorite greens. It's Perlene green. It's a black actually. It's got a black pigment. So why did I paint the sky through? Because there are leaves, right? You know, you don't want to leave. Haha. You don't want to paint one whole flat area. Because the leaves have holes in between them. and they're connected. They're not discrete dots, they're not connected, alright? So basically I paint the sky underneath so that the sky can show through. Make sure I don't touch the wet areas again, otherwise that's gonna happen. More dense at the bottom, alright. So denser it is, the less space you're gonna see between the leaves. Then I can also add some more brownish kind of, mix some paraffin green and some burnt sienna maybe. Can add a bit more branches later. Right. But this is just to suggest something at this point. Lighter shade of it, maybe for the background leaves, branches. much because we want the atmospheric perspective. So just blot, dry out the brush a bit and then pick up the color. Left side should be dry already. So I'm just going to put in the trunk first before I put in the darker tree leaves over it. Some green appetite. I can darken these two. Okay, there's a little tree here, so I'm just going to paint out the negative shape. So you're always alternating between painting out the positive shapes and the negative shapes in watercolors. So I have a bit more smaller brush now for more detail. And what I want to do is start going in and put in the darkest areas, alright? These areas are actually pretty dark. So you can see that I can put in some blacks in between the leaves as well. There are leaves around. So I'm going to, wrong color, that's indigo. Painting the windows now, right? And I leave it to the last. Okay, so there are some pillars, and if you can see, pillars between the doors and the windows. I'm going to leave the pillars white and paint in the doors and the windows. In darker color, right? In this case is going to be a bit of a blackish color. It doesn't have to be perfect black, alright. Probably shouldn't be actually. This area here is a little bit darker than the rest, so I'm going to add a bit more tone because it's inside the corridor under the shade. then you have to let it dry. Okay, we're almost done. Maybe while I wait for that part to dry, I can paint the lamppost. I think that should be sufficiently dry.
Okay.
Right, so just add a bit of leaves, branches in between. Okay, maybe I'll just darken the lamppost a little bit to bring it forward. Because these are already pretty dark, a bit too dark. And if the darker they are, the higher contrast, the less atmospheric perspective you will have. Right. And if I want to define the shape of the house, you can see this side is a bit too low in contrast. What I can do is go in and add slightly a little more sky color. Maybe a bit more blue. It's like this will give a bit more contrast. Cannot do much, or otherwise it will clash. Okay, so final touches, I'm going to just give a bit more contrast to the green at the bottom. Very light green. I want a bit cooler shade now. So I'm going for a bit more sap green. Careful with the lamp. And then on the top side, I'll put some serpentine, which is a bit warmer, especially to this side. Some final touches, some shadows. And I think we can afford to have a bit darker areas here too. Balance out, because down here is very dark, right? If you have too light, then the weight is all on that side. Okay. It's a bit too light too. Okay, just one tiny touch that we can also do, and this I have to be very careful, is if you see on the photograph, there's some railings here, right? And the door goes behind the railings. So what I want to do is I just want to put some vertical lines to do some negative painting to show the door through the railings. And I have to be very careful. Alright. There you go. A little subtle, but hopefully that makes it pop a little bit. Okay, so you know, you can go in and darken some of the shadow areas. Add a bit of contrast, and that will help to make your sketch pop. Alright, so I'll just consider this done. I don't want to overwork it too much. And pity is I didn't take photo of the sketch before I painted it. That would have been more helpful. Alright, so that's it for the demo today. I hope you enjoyed it. See you again soon!